Every word Jesus spoke is life to those of us who trust in him as Lord and Savior. Yet there's something especially poignant about his dying words, and the gospel writers left us a record of seven sayings Jesus spoke from the cross. And so today we begin a new series of devotions based on Jesus' last words. In a frenzy of envy, the most respectable men of the age manipulated their legal system to get an innocent man crucified. Jesus was stripped, beaten, and nailed to the cross while they hurled insults. Then he, who had been silent as a lamb led to the slaughter, finally opened his parched lips and began to speak. But what will he say? Will he beg for mercy? Will he curse his accusers? Listen carefully, not just to the first words Jesus uttered from the cross, but for words that no man had ever spoken from a cross before. He said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." Luke 23:34. When his feet could no longer carry him on missions of mercy, or his hands minister to the sick, he fulfilled an ancient prophecy by praying for the guilty. 700 years earlier, the prophet Isaiah had written these words regarding the Messiah. "Therefore I will divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out his soul unto death, and was numbered with the transgressors, and he bore the sins of many, and made intercession for the transgressors." Isaiah 53:12. So that's what Jesus did then and there for them. But what about us today? Well, he continues to make intercession. He continues to pray for those who come to the Father through him. In fact, Hebrews 9:24-25 says this, "Because Jesus lives forever, he has a permanent priesthood. Therefore, he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them." You see, the one who was crucified and prayed for his enemies is now risen and alive and seated at the right hand of God, making intercession for you and for me today. And so let us, with boldness, come to the Father through the Son.